House Bill 2142, or the PA Fertility Act, would ensure the availability of fertility services throughout Pennsylvania's healthcare insurance marketplaces. As many as 1.5 Pennsylvanians could use medical help to start families. But PA is the lone Northeast state without a law protecting or defining fertility treatment within its healthcare insurance markets. Every one of our neighbor states protects fertility treatment by law. This bill would help make having a family a right in Pennsylvania. One of the main reasons we are all here today is to bring awareness to infertility treatment. Infertility means not being able to get pregnant after 1 year of trying, or 6 months if a woman is 35 years or older. Women who can get pregnant but are unable to stay pregnant may be termed infertile. However, there are as many male factors that contribute to infertility as there are female factors. 1/3 of infertility cases are caused by male reproductive issues, 1/3 are caused by female reproductive issues, and the final third are caused by a combination of the two or unknown causes. Couples who are same-sex, single people, and people who are transgender seek fertility treatment services in their healthcare plans as well. Infertility services can include hormone injections and invasive procedures. Depending on insurance coverage, it can be an expensive process, and it can also take a tremendous emotional toll. Feelings of inadequacy and guilt are often part of the journey. Meanwhile, failed pregnancies, even though they can be expected in many cases, remain heartbreaking and life-changing. On top of that, many people feel the pressure to start a family while advancing a career that might or might not come with healthcare insurance benefits that cover fertility treatment. This tug of war can produce stress, jealousy, and despair, and none of which are conducive to becoming pregnant. I'm no stranger to this. My wife Rachel and I have been attempting to start a family for close to a decade. Following my diagnosis by my pediatrician many years ago, I've known that having a family would be very difficult for me and for us. So I realized, however, I have been blessed in many ways, and unlike many people across Pennsylvania, I've had the ease of treatment because of where I grew up in Montgomery County. From my initial treatment at CHOP and Penn to my transition to a local and caring physician in Montgomery County, I found the help that I needed. But I realize access to local specialists is not a reality for many residents living in rural Pennsylvania. I'm also one of the lucky ones, considering my union, the Teamsters, covered the medication that I needed. Out-of-pocket expenses can be unreasonably high, and that alone can add another level of stress for expecting parents. A lack of insurance coverage and a lack of finances can end the dream of starting a family before it even begins for many Pennsylvanians. Even with all these benefits in our favor, our journey to start a family has been difficult. There have been times when we have not found the medication that I needed because of stocking and manufacturing issues. Specialized fertility medications are controlled on the federal level, and local pharmacies do not offer these medications to patients, so patients must use specialty pharmacies for their medication needs. And during the pandemic, the specialty pharmacy did not have the medication that I needed. So we looked throughout the state and region with no success at all. Going without medication had a really negative effect on my body. And even when we finally acquired the medication that I needed, I had to start my regimen all over again, from scratch. So in other words, it took another 3 months of taking medication before we could then restart the clock on the process of attempting to have a family. So in closing, I want to highlight that my journey is not unique, and as you'll hear from others on stage, infertility is a human struggle. It's an issue that affects many people, cutting across all borders and boundaries to touch people regardless of gender or race or sexual orientation or political party. So it's with certainty that I can say that this bill has the potential to help thousands of Pennsylvanians. It's my hope that you will join us in advocating for House Bill 2142 and support the PA Fertility Act.